circle the smaller fraction 1/4, 3/4. Here we have one numerator, four denominator. Here we have three numerator, four denominator. Means denominators are same. So I told you that smaller numerator is a smaller fraction. So here 7/8, 3/8. 3/8 is smaller. So this is a smaller fraction. Here we have 1/5, 4/5. One numerator, five denominator. Here 4 as a numerator, 5 as a denominator. When denominators are same, then smaller numerator is a smaller fraction. Here 11, 8 both are numerators. 13, 13 both are denominator. So 8 upon 13 is a smaller fraction. Now here we have circle the greatest fraction. Now 4/9, 6/9, 7/9. 4/9, 6/9, 7/9. Here we have 9 as a denominator. 9 as a denominator. So greater numerator is greater fraction. So 4, 6, 7. 7 is greater numerator. So that is greater fraction. Here we have 2/9, 5/9, 8/9. So which one is greater? 8/9. As here we have greater numerator. Here we have 4/11, 2/11, 8/11. So 4 numerator, 11 denominator. Here we have 2 numerator, 11 denominator, 8 upon 11. So greater numerator with the same denominator is greater. So 8/11 is greater. So here we have 6/7, 4/7, 3/7. Which one is greater? Greater numerator. 6/7 is greater. So again, once again, I am repeating that if we have same denominator, it's very easy. Smaller numerator is smaller and greater numerator is greater. So always just look at here. Same denominator, then you go to numerator. 4, 6, 7, 7 is greater. 4, 2, 8, 8 is greater. 6, 4, 3, 6 is greater. 2, 5, 8, 8 is greater. 11, 8, 8 is smaller. 7, 3, 3 is smaller. So take care for that. Keep your eye on numerator and then compare the number. Write the following fractions in ascending order. Ascending order means smaller to bigger. First we have to compare the fractions. As we have same denominator, means smaller number is smaller fraction. So which one is smaller? 6, 9, 7, 3. 3/10. Then after 3, which one is there? Now compare these three. 6, 9, 7. So 6/10. Then compare these two. This we have done. This we have done. Now compare 9/10, 7/10. So 7/10 is smaller. Then last is 9/10. That is bigger one. So this is ascending order. 3/10, 6/10, 7/10, 9/10. And from here we have descending. 9, 7, 6, 3. Bigger to smaller. Here we have ascending. 3, 6, 7, 9. So we have 3/10, 6/10, 7/10, 9/10. These are ascending order fractions. Now here we have 2/7, 6/7, 3/7, 5/7. So denominators are same. So which one is smaller? 2/7. Now this is we have done. Now compare these three. 3/7 is smaller. This we have done. Now compare these two. 5/7 is smaller. Then last is 6/7. So small ascending order is 2/7, 3 by 7, 5 by 7, 6 by 7. So write the following fractions in descending order. 2 by 8, 6 by 8, 1 upon 8, 4 upon 8. Now denominator we have same 8, 8, 8, 8. Descending means bigger to smaller. First you take 6, then you take 4, then 2, then 1. 6 upon 8, 4 upon 8, 2 upon 8, 1 upon 8. So this is descending order. 6 by 8, 4 by 8, 2 by 8, 1 by 8. Bigger to smaller. Very simple. Now here we have 9 upon 10, 3 upon 10, 1 upon 10, 5 upon 10. Denominator is same. So greater numerator is greater fraction. So first take 9, then 5, then 3, then 1. 9 upon 10, then 5 upon 10, then 3 upon 10, and then at the end. So this is descending order, greater to smaller. 6, 4, 2, 1. 9, 5, 3, 1. So bigger to smaller. These are descending orders. Now here we have finding the fractions of a collection. Means Seema had 8 books. She had to give half of these to her friend. Half means 1 by 2. How many books did she give? Now here we have 8 books. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We divide 8 by 2. Half of the part means divide 8 by 2. 8 by 2. You call the table of 2 and stop on 8. 2 fours are 8. So 2 fours are 8. So 4 books she had to give away. 4 books. Again, whenever we have a number and we have to do a part of that number, we will divide. What we will do? We will divide. Now 8 books, half of these means 8 divided by 2. Half means 1 by 2. So 8 divided by 2. We have 4 books. Manju was carrying 6 apples of which she dropped 1 by 3. Means 1 by 3. 1 by 3 of 6. How many apples did she drop? Now 3 groups of 6 apples. First we will make 3 groups of 6 apples. Means 1 by 3 of 6. We have to divide 6 by 3. So we have 2 apples. She dropped 2 apples. Whenever we have fixed number and part, means 1 upon 3 of 6. What is the meaning? 1 upon 3 of 6. So we will divide 6 by 3. 3 twos are 6. So we have 2 apples.